الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، حبيت في الله. It's imperative for us to follow the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And again, that requires that we have knowledge of the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And that means that we have to restrain our desires and our inclinations to follow other paths, other manahij, other methodologies and ways, thinking that those ways will give us satisfaction and give us success in this life and or the next. And so there are so many narrations and so many ayat from Allah Azza wa Jal to show us the importance of being one ummah and adhering to that which Allah wa Rasuluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa'ati'u Allah wa'ati'u Rasul, obey Allah and obey His Messenger. So those people who are obedient to Allah and obedient to His Messenger, meaning that this is their masdar, this is their origin of where they take their religion from. They begin there. They begin with the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Sabil al-Mu'mineen, the path of the believers, which is the methodology of the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, the manhaj of the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, meaning what the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een were upon. And this is just a beautiful statement from Imam Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala. He said, wa ma'loom an ahla hadith hum a'zam tawa'if al-umma bahthan wa ma'rafatan bi sunnati rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa la yunaza fi thalika illa aduun lillah wa li rasulihi wa li ibadihi al-mu'mineen. Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala, one of the sons of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, it is well known that Ahla Hadith, they are the greatest group or sect of this ummah with regards to research, with regards to understanding or knowledge of the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then taking out some of the statements he said and going on to what is quoted here, and no one disputes this except for an enemy of Allah and His Messenger and the worshipers from the believers. So this shows us the importance, ahabatifillah, of striving our best to not just take names and giving ourselves names and titles and associating with groups without having striving to be better, striving to gain knowledge, striving to learn, striving to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without, and it's an obligation to have ikhlas wa mutaba'ah, to be sincere in your seeking of knowledge and following and adhering to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that this is for your deeds to be accepted. It doesn't come with your name. Just because you call yourself Ahla Hadith, or you call yourself from Ahla Iman, a mu'min, or you call yourself from Ahla Athar, or you call yourself this title or that title, or this group or that group, as the scholars mention, al-ibra bi haqaiq laysa bi musammiyat, that the reality of something is in its substance, not in its name. So it's very important that we learn to love and practice and understand the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that we command the good and forbid the evil, and that we encourage one another, and that we follow the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said ad-din an-nasiha, that he said the religion is sincere advice, so that we advise one another when we make mistakes, when we can help one another, we can assist one another, not that we follow up each other's mistakes in order to destroy, belittle, and attack and to bring raise ourselves up. So it's very important that we become sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us to be from Ahl al-Ikhlas, from the Mukhlisin. And those who follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us of our many sins and shortcomings. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.